In the last class, we studied Ladakh, Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, and today we are going to work out on Uttarakhand, Rajasthan, Gujarat, and Maharashtra. Uttarakhand is a very beautiful state in India. It is formed in year 2000. As 27th state of India. It is also called Devbhumi, the land of gods, because there are so many important shrines and pilgrimage routes. The state is divided into two regions. One is Gadwal and the other one is Kumaon. These are also having distinct cultural features. We have Chardham Yatra, conducted annually in the month of May end till November, having trip to Yamunotri, Gangotri, Kedarnath and Badrinath. And during the month of May end or beginning of June, Hemkund Sahib opens, and this is a very important shrine for Sikh pilgrims. So let us have the important places of Uttarakhand. As I told you earlier, we have Gadwal region and Kumaon region. And the pilgrimage traffic, one is originating from Haridwar Rishikesh route and the other one is from Nainital route. From Haridwar, Rishikesh is the next immediate point where large number of people reach and stay there for quite some time, take part in river rafting, and those who are interested who move further to explore the beautiful landscapes. And in that route we have also Mussoorie coming. Mussoorie is a very popular place, many movies shot in the background of this hill station, and it is also known for training our officers. The IAS Academy is also situated in Mussoorie. Then Chakrata is a very beautiful but less known hill station of Uttarakhand. From Dehradun you can take a route through Vigasnagar, and within a time of 3 hours you can reach Chakrata. And when you move from Chakrata to further interior areas of Uttarakhand, you come across Kote Kanasar, Tuna, and the road goes up to the borders of Himachal Pradesh. A particular tribal community living here are called Jonsar Babar tribes. Because of their ethnic identity and cultural features, then we have Oli. Oli is a skiing center, and it is also a popular place for people who want to spend their summer time. Ahead we can find Joshimath. From Joshimath people also go to Valley of Flowers National Park. Hemkund Sahib is very near here. Hemkund Sahib involves a trek of almost 20 kilometers one way through a difficult terrain. We have other places like Lansdowne. We have Gobeshwar. From Nainital area, if you go further, we can find Almora. You must have heard about Almora a lot. This Almora Pitoragad road is also connecting with Kailas Mansarovar road. The top of the hill is called Bugyal. Bugyal means the meadows spread over an area, and you can mainly find then this at an altitude of around 2500 meters above sea level. Some examples of Bugyal are Oli, Dadni, Tunganath and Dayara. Now let me take you to Rajasthan. Rajasthan is mainly known for palaces, forts and the heritage of this state. But we have one hill station called Mount Abu. The former name of Mount Abu was Arbudanjal. It is situated at an altitude of 1220 meters above sea level. And it is this particular hill station, it is in Arvelli Hills. When we find other hill stations, we have discussed about the hill stations in Himalayan range. Mount Abu, it is also a religious place, and mainly Jains, the Jain pilgrims, they visit the tallest peak which you find here is Guru Shikhar. Naki Lake, the lake surrounded within the hills. Then Todd Rock, James Todd was an explorer. He explored Rajasthan during the time of British, and the rock shaped in the size of a frog is called a Todd Rock. Kumari Ashram is also located here. And Dilwara Temples, one of the very famous temples known for architecture. All the temples are made in pure white marble, and a series of these temples can be found in Mount Abu. Mount Abu is very close to Udaipur. The visitors to Mount Abu, you can find maximum are from Gujarat, because from here to Ahmedabad, the land distance is very less. We have one hill station in Gujarat. Perhaps you may not have heard about this before. Sabutara. Sabutara is a hill station which is situated at an altitude of 875 meters in Dang district of Gujarat. This is very close to Maharashtra border. The lush green landscape, waterfalls, winding roads attract people to spend their weekends in Sabutara in Gujarat. Maharashtra is having a number of hill stations, and most of these hill stations we may find in TV serials background or movies, because it has a unique landscape. You might have heard about Mahabaleshwar, Panchgani, Lonavala, Matheran. These are the major hill stations of Maharashtra. Mahabaleshwar is nestled in Western Ghats, the hills of Western Ghats, and it has a beautiful lake. Pratapgarh, one fort built by Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, that also we can find here. Then this place is also known for mulberry farming. It is a very popular place for people from Maharashtra. Panchgani is very near to Mahabaleshwar. We have Lonavala. Lonavala is known for the land, tabletop land, which normally we hear from South Africa. And when you travel from Manmad to Mumbai, the train passes through a very beautiful landscape. You can observe, if you have not seen, you can observe it in your next trip. Mahabaleshwar is 120 kilometers from Pune. Matheran. Matheran is a hill station. Matheran has Sunset Point, Garbutt Point route, Rambuk Point route, One Tree Hill, Vigadgat route, and the nearest railway station is Neral. So it is 100 kilometers from Mumbai and 120 kilometers from Pune. The summary of today's discussion is, we started with Uttarakhand. We saw two regions, Kumau and Gadwal, that is Mussoorie, Chakrata. Chakrata is near to Mussoorie. Nainital, Almora, Pitorgarh. We studied Rajasthan. Mount Abu is the major hill station of Rajasthan. Nakhi Lake, Todd Rock, Brahmakumari Ashram, Dilwara Temples, Guru Shikhar, the peak. When we study Gujarat, we saw Saputara. It's situated on the borders of Maharashtra. And again, it is in the Western Ghats. Mahabaleshwar, Lonavala, Panchgani, and Matheran. These are the places that we saw in Maharashtra.